Yeah, there's a QR code.
Oh, there's a QR code.
Yeah, but you do know.
And it's the QR code downstairs.
Uh-huh. There's a big sign in the lobby.
Thank you. evening and welcome. We're going to start that clock off by about 5 minutes, so it's actually pretty close to 7:30. And this is our festival concert. So for the choirs as well as the band, we will be performing some of the music we did at festival as well as some others. So this is the high school band. I want to remind you, you can take all the photographs you want with your phones, you can record with your phones, but make sure the sound is off or on vibrate, and make sure you're not texting and doing those other things that would be considered somewhat rude. So this, again, is the high school band. Thank you for coming this evening. We're going to open with a great march that has kind of, it's a British march that has World War II kind of sound to it. And this is called Glory. Thank you. Our second number, we're going to do a piece by my favorite composer of all time, even more than Wagner, and that is Percy Grainger, who was originally from Australia, and then he moved to England to do some schooling there, and that's where he studied music. He did a lot of English folk songs and brought that genre into the band world, so to speak. And then he moved to the U.S. and eventually became a U.S. citizen. And Percy Grainger's music is considered some of the great, great literature for band. And so he did one that was called Lincolnshire Posy. And the music's pretty difficult stuff. And then Sweeney decided to take a couple movements of this Lincolnshire Posy and score it slightly easier, not a lot easier, but slightly easier, and in a better, more playable key so that younger kids could experience the music. It's really wonderful music. And so this is one of my favorites, and this is, I think it's originally was the sixth movement, the last movement of Lincolnshire Posy. And it's called Lost Lady Found.
Thank you.
piece we're gonna do is our contest piece, it's a little longer than the other. Probably about the same length if you take the other two and combine them. Probably about how long this last one's gonna be. It was the piece that we did for contest. That we recorded on Friday, that was Tuesday, since it was all uploaded and recorded this year. So, piece, it's called The Light Eternal by James Swearengen. And it is a descriptive, emotional piece of something that happened during World War II. There was a troop transport going across the ocean, and there were three different chaplains, so to speak. Okay, so you had a Protestant, it sounds like a joke, it isn't. You had a Protestant, you had a Catholic, and then you had Jewish. And what happened was this boat was torpedoed by a German U-boat and sunk, and they were there to help the men that were panicking, obviously, as much as they could, and they gave up their own lifeboats and such to save the men. And the men still tell stories of seeing as the ship was sinking below the waves of the three different faiths. Chaplains linking their elbows and saying prayers in different languages. And they were
thank you. sophomores. I don't know what's coming up. They're just back here. Yeah. Get up that heavy and take a muscle. Yeah.
Offshore Bird, which is a traditional English canon. It is beginning with a lovely solo. Their Will Be Rest by Frank Ticelli. This is an a cappella piece that uses a lot of ethereal sounds to it. So some of the notes you may think, that's a little crunchy, and they're supposed to be. So it's just part of the spice. Enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
traditional spiritual a cappella style, arranged by Emily Crocker. I want to thank you all again for coming out tonight, and have a great evening.